Kevin Seymour is the Managing Director of Woomera Mining. He joins me now to talk about a whole lot of different things, including a 5 kilometre avocado. We'll explain more about that later. But Kevin, let's just start off with your Mount Venn nickel, copper and gold project in Western Australia. It's obviously a focus. Tell us about the latest there.
Well, Carl, thanks for having me. The Mount Venn gold, nickel, copper project is located 125 kilometres northeast of Laverton in the northeastern fields of Western Australia. And it's 40 kilometres west of the giant 6 million ounce Groya gold mine owned by Goldfields and Couple Road. We've got over 50 kilometres strike of the greenstone belt, and we believe there's going to be more gold discoveries to be had in that belt. But our main focus in the short term is our nickel copper prospect called Mt Cornell, which is up on the northern end of our land package. Now, just before Christmas, we announced some very exciting nickel and copper massive sulfide intersections, 11 metres of 0.34% nickel and 0.42% copper. Now, we're highly encouraged by these intersections because they're the first drill intersections into the Sill complex. Now, I was explaining to Carl that the Sill, think of it as an avocado, a giant, if you like, 5 kilometre long by 3 kilometre wide avocado. And we chop that in half and the stones sticking out of the avocado. That stone is the outcrop that you see on the ground. That's our indication that the Sill exists. The mushy green bit of the avocado is the ultramafic that surrounds that, and the dark green outside of the avocado is where the massive sulfides will accumulate. And that's our exploration target. The perimeter of that avocado is 15 kilometres long and down to 500 metres deep. So you get a sense of how big this mafic sill can be as an exploration play. And our drilling is only just scratching the top northeastern corner of that avocado. And those intersections are within 100 metres of surface. So we've got a lot of drilling to do, a lot of exploration to do in order to better evaluate the full size potential and the continuity of the massive sulfide intersections. Our holes at the moment are 500 metres apart, and they're the only holes that have targeted this sill complex. All the previous exploration, including some earlier holes that we drilled ourselves, failed to intercept through the stone of the avocado into the green mushy bit, and they certainly didn't penetrate through to the skin of the avocado. So we're very, very excited by the opportunity that this creates for our exploration work going forward. And we'll be out there drilling again as soon as we get all the regulatory approvals in place, sometime in March, hopefully, and get the truth machine back out there and drill some holes and hopefully get some more success with our intersections.
Okay, excellent. So it sounds like there's a lot more than perhaps you had initially hoped for there. Now, I just want to know, how about the rest of the program? I believe you've got some assays in the labs at the moment, due any day. I guess that's what investors should be keeping an eye out for in the short term?
Yeah, absolutely. Just before we moved on to the nickel copper targets at Mount Cornell, we focused our effort on the Three Bears gold prospect, which extends over 7 kilometres long, of which 4 kilometres or so has been RC drilled. And we're getting some very broad zones of mineralisation within those. It's a very large gold system. And given our proximity to the 6 million ounce Groya gold mine, we seriously believe there's potential for a significant discovery to be held within our land package. Gold deposits cluster. There's usually every 30 kilometres up the highways you go north of Kalgoorlie. So to have a 6 million ounce gold mine sitting out at Yamana Greenstone Belt all on its lonesome is unusual for the eastern goldfields. We expect to find more, and we've got a very large gold system. So we're chipping away at that in order to try and find the higher grade component of that. And we finished our second phase of drilling out there in October last year. Unfortunately, we're still waiting for the assay results. Like every other junior explorer in Western Australia, the turnaround from the assay laboratories is very slow. We're hoping to get some numbers in the next week or so, which we'll obviously report to the market as soon as they're available. And that's looking for some higher grade components of our Three Bears system. And I suppose it's just a question of watch this space. Hopefully we'll see some numbers in the next week or so.
Okay, Kevin Seymour, Managing Director of Woomera Mining. Looking forward to those updates when the labs are finally able to get those out to you. And of course, with the rest of the projects, nickel, copper, gold, sounds like there's a lot going on there.
Absolutely. Yeah, and it's a very exciting moment for us at the time.
Okay, thanks very much.
Cheers. Thank you very much indeed.